Dear learners, I am Dr. Sri Lakshmi Potlori, Assistant Professor in Umang Gitai Women's College of Women Education and Counselor for MSc Dietetics and Food Service Management at IGNU, Nagpur Regional Center. Today, we are focusing on the topic phytates. Phytate, the salt of phytic acid, is widely distributed in the plant kingdom. It serves as a storage form of phosphorus and minerals and contain nearly 75% of total phosphorus of the kernels. Other parts of plants such as roots, tubers and tunions, however, are very low in phytate. Beside phytate, other inositol phosphate such as inositol pentaphosphates and inositol tetraphosphates are also present in seeds. For decades, phytate has been regarded as an anti-nutrient, as during gastrointestinal passage, it may inhibit the absorption of some minerals, trace elements, which under certain dietary circumstances may lead to calcium, iron and zinc deficiencies. Thus, intensive research has been carried out to remove phytate from food by proper processing. To improve the bioavailability and to avoid deficiencies of essential trace elements and minerals, in the last 20 years, however, beneficial properties of phytate have been observed and antioxidant and anti-cancer activities were reported. Inhibition of calcium salt crystallization and prevention of renal stool formation through dietary phytate were described. Reduction of starch digestion along with slowing down of glycemic index of foods have also been reported, as well as positive effects on blood glucose and blood cholesterol were observed. In this module, we shall study the definition, sources, metabolism, physiological effects and health effects of phytates. Objectives: this module will acquaint learners with origin and history of phytates, definition, sources and effect of processing. Phytates widely occurs in whole grains, legumes, seeds and nuts. It has received considerable attention due to its effect on mineral absorption. Phytic acid has strong binding affinity to dietary minerals and impairs the absorption of iron, zinc, manganese and lesser extent calcium. History: the discovery of phytate dates from 1855 to 1856 when Hartig first reported small round particles in various plant seeds which are similar to size to potato starch grains. Using the iodine test, he showed that the particles were free of starch and concluded that they must contain reserve nutrients for the germination of seeds. Later, it was discovered that isolated particles were rich in phosphorus, calcium, magnesium, but neither contained proteins nor lipids. The name phytin was created by virtue of the fact that this substance is of plant origin. Let us discuss chemistry and occurrence. Most plant foodstuffs contain inositol, which is present in the form of myo-inositol hexokinase phosphate, that is phytic acid, and its salts. In seeds, inositol is storage form of phosphate and 60 to 70% of phosphate is present as phytate. Phytic acid is generally complexed with minerals and or proteins. The complexed form with minerals is known as phytates. Phosphorus in phytate form is in general not bioavailable to non-ruminant animals because they lack digestive enzyme phytase, which is required to separate phosphorus from the phytate molecule. Given figure depicts the structure of phytic acid. Next, we come to sources of phytates in foods. The main source of phytate in daily diet are cereals and legumes. including oil seeds and nuts. They are important for human nutrition and represent nearly 40% and 60% of total caloric intake for humans. In cereals, phytates is located in the alluron layer and the germ, while the endosperm is almost free of phytate. Approximately 80% of phytate is located in the alluron layer of small grains like wheat, rice, etc. Cereals are rich in phytate and contain nearly 1% phytic acid on the dry matter basis, ranging from 0.06 to nearly 2% dry weight of it. Cereal food products, however, may show higher phytic acid contents. In legume seeds, phytate predominantly occurs in the protein bodies of the endosperm or the cotyledon, containing up to 90% of the total phytic acid. In the whole seed, the phytic acid content varies from 0.2% to 2.9% of its dry weight. In oil seeds such as sunflower, kernels, soybean, soybean products, sesame seeds, linseeds and rape seeds, the phytic acid content ranges from 1 to 5.4%. In nuts, the fourth group of phytate-rich foods such as hazelnuts, walnuts, almonds and cashew nuts. The phytic acid content of nut varies from 0.1% to 9.4% of its dry weight. In mature cereal grains, legumes and oil seeds, the major portion of total phosphorus is present in the form of phytic acid. In general, vegetarians consume a higher amount of phytate compared to non-vegetarians. Phytate intake also varies with season. Now, we will be looking into effect of processing. Because phytate is heat stable, significant phytate reduction during cooking is not expected unless either the cooking water was discarded or food received additional processing treatment such as soaking, germination, fermentation, etc. Another possible mechanism by which phytate reduction can occur during cooking is phytate hydrolysis due to activation of the endogenous phytases or phosphatases. During the early part of cooking phase, myo-inositol hexaphosphate phosphohydrolase EC3138 and EC3126 are found in plants, microorganisms and in animal tissues as well. They hydrolyze phytate as well as other organic phosphates like inositol phosphate, nucleotides, etc. However, with different affinity and efficacy, the presence of acid and alkalis during cooking may also contribute phytate hydrolysis. Typically, cooking allows a significant reduction in phytate, that is up to 50% in most cases. However, phytate reduction is possible when cooking is combined with certain other treatments. Pressure cooking like autoclaving typically causes higher phytate reduction than cooking under atmospheric pressure. During germination, reserve nutrients are mobilized to provide for the growth of roots and shoots. Phytate, being a major source of phosphorus, is hydrolyzed by endogenous enzymes to release inorganic phosphorus. Phytase activity increases considerably during germination. The type of microorganism, the fermentation conditions used, and starting amount of phytate present in the raw material significantly affect the extent of phytate removal. A number of studies indicate an appreciable decrease in phytate content during storage. The extent of such reduction depends on the type of seed, storage conditions, especially relative humidity and temperature, and the age of the seed, like fresh pod versus dry seeds. Few studies have reported radiation to be effective in phytate removal from seeds and grains. Dear learners, with this, we will conclude this module. Phytic acid, mostly present in the form of phytin, is found within the hulls of seed, including nuts, grains, and pulses. Phytic acid has been regarded as the primitive storage form of both phosphate and inositol in almost all seeds. The amount of phytic acid varies from 0.5% to 1.89% in cereals. Exception is polished rice, from 0.4% to 2.6% in legumes, from 2% to 5.20% in oil seeds, and from 0.4% to 7.5% in protein products. In food preparation techniques, can break down the phytic acid. Simply, cooking food will reduce phytic acid to some degree. Most effective methods are soaking in an acid medium, sprouting, and lactic acid fermentation such as sourdough and pickling. Phytic acid is used as a food additive and also as food preservative.